If you're out there developing your own game, you're inevitably going to, at some point, arrive to a place where you want critical feedback or someone else's opinion on the product that you've been working on. But many times, this can be difficult not only to receive but also to process. I mean, that game is probably your baby, it's something you loathe and it's something you've put hundreds of hours into. You don't really want to see it torn apart by some outside critic who has no idea of how much work you've put in. Well, as painful as it is, critical and relevant feedback is of utmost importance for a game to eventually be good, because honestly, no game is perfect out of the box, and a lot of times, outside opinion can help you see stuff that you simply would normally overlook because you've spent hundreds of hours looking into that game previously. Anyways, today I will quickly go over how to properly ask for feedback, how to record it, how to receive it, and finally, how to select which points of feedback are relevant to you and which should just be discarded. Anyways, with that out of the way, grab your QA experience, get a questionnaire, and let's go. Now first of all, it is extremely important to select the proper audience. If you've done a good job analyzing the design of your game, maybe creating a global design document, you will know what the target audience for your game is. Now these are the people that you should be mostly concerned with. However, there's one thing that is very dangerous when only asking the people you're directly developing for, and that's the echo chamber effect. Many companies suffer from this if they only ask feedback from their fans or people that are closely related to the development of that game, because you will find yourself surrounded by so-called yes men or people who simply support and tell you that everything you've done is perfect and that no more work needs to be put into that aspect. Now the reason why that's problematic is because number one, it does not allow you to see the faults that the game might have and that the public will definitely be very critical of once the game comes out. And following up on that, when the feedback from the audience arrives, it is going to be extra hard for you because, well, all you've experienced up to this point has been positive feedback, so why the hell is the game not doing too well? Of course, at the same time, while going out there and asking completely random strangers feedback on your game might be some sort of a useful research data thing, if you're looking for truly relevant and critical feedback, you should ask people that are somewhat understanding of the industry, gamers themselves or other developers, but some that you know will provide honest and ideally unbiased feedback to what you're showing them. Now when it comes to asking for feedback itself, of course you have to ask often and ask plenty. You should be asking for opinions on your product as soon as you have something playable, often even before that, as there might be big obvious flaws or mistakes that you're simply overlooking and that someone from the outside might help identify. You shouldn't, however, just walk up to someone and ask, well, what do you think about my game? Because the feedback you're going to receive is never going to be relevant to what you're actually looking for. One of the best points of advice I have for QA is to ask in small chunks. If you've built a new level, don't just ask the person, what do you think of this level, and leave it at that. Instead, break it down into smaller pieces and ask more specific questions. The more specific the question is, the more specific and direct answer you're going to get. As an example, when I was developing a level for a platformer, I wanted to make sure that the difficulty ramps up evenly throughout the level. Now what I did is I broke the level down into 8 or so different pieces. I had the player play through the level 3 times, and then I showed them the picture of each of those 8 phases and I asked them to rank them based on difficulty. This way I was able to get direct feedback on how they felt each of those chunks was difficult, especially compared to the other ones in the level. On the same note, do not make people fill out huge forms at the end of playtests because it's simply annoying. If your questions are direct to the point or even ideally rankings from 1 to 10 or ticking a box, they'll give the playtester a much easier time and they will also allow you to have a easier time collecting and analyzing the feedback. On the final note of asking for feedback, you should always observe and then ask. Make sure you observe the player's reaction as they play your game. Do they get stuck on something? Do they look like they're getting frustrated? Remember that a lot of the feedback is not going to be verbal. You have to look at their playstyle and make small notes, which is another way you can skip asking your playtester to fill out a huge questionnaire at the end of their session. Now, when you're receiving feedback, I think the most important point is to always be polite. Yes, a lot of the feedback can be critical and it can sound like an attack directly to your person, but in 99% of the cases, it will not be. It's just people giving their honest opinion. So my advice in this area is to never argue with the feedback. Always accept it no matter what it is. And then on your own, you're going to be able to decide which of those points to discard and which of them to use. However, you should never do that in front of the playtester. But alright, let's say you've gathered the feedback, you've tested a lot, you've tested multiple versions of the game, and now you have all this feedback and all these points noted down around you. So how do you select which of them are relevant and which of them you should simply discard? Well, it is at this point where you have to simply revert back to what your game was initially meant to be. If you've watched my previous video on the MDA model, that is a perfect starting point for this. Revert back to the global design document, think of the experience that you intended the game to give to the player. If your game is supposed to be a fast-paced, action-packed shooter like Doom, but people are giving you feedback that they don't like the puzzle parts that they're getting stuck on, this might be the time to reconsider adding or removing those parts. Of course, also pay attention to how many people say the same thing, because if you get a big percentage of your playtesting base giving you the same points, well, chances are those are the ones you should look into first. If out of 100, 99 people like the gore and one doesn't, well, you're of course not going to be removing it just for that one person. In the end, there's no direct way to simply select which feedback is perfect. You have to do it yourself because it's heavily dependent on the game that you're developing for. But before discarding any points, make sure you look into what your game was originally intended to be and whether those points don't contradict them. And of course, never throw out any of the feedback, because at least at the end of the development, you're going to be able to complete a nice postmortem document for other developers and studios to learn from on their future projects. Anyways, that is it from me. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, maybe consider leaving a like, commenting, or subscribing. All of those would be very much appreciated. If you think there's anything I missed, or anything that you think people would be interested in to know more about, make sure to leave that down in the comments as well. I'd be interested to read it. That is it for me. I wish you all a beautiful rest of today, and I'm gonna see you in whatever next video I make. Bye bye.